lovely night and such a nice breeze, too. Truthfully, I find such festivities quite tedious. I'm afraid I'm becoming quite tired.
Please, rest here, Princess Charlotte.
Huh? Hmm? Oh my! Why, thank you.
Wait. You intend to go looking like that? You'll just end up embarrassing him. If you must speak to him, then wait until the princess is gone. I'm borrowing this.
Why are most men so preoccupied by bloodshed? That is what you asked me on the hunting grounds, is it not?
Yes.
It's true that men possess a side that is rather savage, as you have already observed. But its purpose is to win things that are precious, as well as protect them. You could say it's like a double-edged sword.
Our precious things? Those you love? Honor?
Love and honor are both important things. They are the things a knight is willing to die for. It's the reason they take up arms. However, for a man, I believe there is something that goes beyond that. Something even more precious.
Something more precious?
They are driven to pursue it. So driven, they do it entirely for their own sake. It's their dream. A dream. Men yearn for their dreams, regardless of their class, and no matter what their achievements have been. One can be sustained by their dream, hurt by their dream, revived by their dream, or even killed by it. And though one might be abandoned by his own dream, even then it will smolder in his heart forever. One should know what it feels like to strive for such goals, to willingly martyr yourself to the God-named dream. I find it abhorrent to simply live out my life for no other reason than I was born into it. I apologize. I hope I haven't been boring you, Princess.
No. Lord Griffin, you are such a marvelous person. You are more noble than aristocrats we call nobles. But on the day of the hunt, when you taught me how to play the leaf, you seemed like an innocent little child. But when you shared your thoughts, you were like a philosopher. I think you're amazing. I'm sure your friends are equally fascinated by you. I'm certain it's what attracts them to you.
They are my soldiers, and they will follow me into the jaws of death for the sake of my dream. But it doesn't make them my friends. A friend should never subsist on another's dream. The man who would be my friend must have a reason for living that goes beyond me. And he should put his heart and soul into protecting this dream, even if it means opposing me. For me to call a man my friend, he must be my equal in every respect.
Lord Griffin, would you share your dream with me?
Princess!